My name is Robert Rush, and I'm a senior at Harvard University. I grew up in the South Bronx to a wonderful single mother who believed in the power of education. She really worked to put me in the right institution. From third grade on, I was put in a talented and gifted school that through working hard, by the time I graduated, I was able to attend a private boarding school in Massachusetts called Phillips Academy Andover. I continued to excel academically and also extracurricularly, affording me a scholarship to Harvard University.
We've been through some struggles and you was right there with me.
Yeah, I know. It seems like every step was a struggle. but somehow, some way, we made it work.
My first impression of Harvard came when I was applying and I didn't like the institution. I thought it was going to be full of people who were pretentious and wouldn't understand me. I realized that just because this environment seems so disconnected from me doesn't mean that it wouldn't be able to take me in as its own. As soon as I got to Harvard, I saw 15, 16, 20 black students all walking around, all feeling like they owned the campus and super excited to meet me and greet me and get to know me. And it really made me feel comfortable.
I think many students of color, from the moment they come to campus, you know, they seek refuge in each other. I completely get that. I think faculty of color do the same thing.
So the Black Students Association at Harvard is an organization that has provided support, events, forums, discussions, and all kinds of activities for all Black students at Harvard.
It is the only place where you'll go where you'll find so many different perspectives, so many different backgrounds, and so many different experiences, and all of which are represented by students who are willing to talk to you and invest in you and take the time to help you navigate Harvard in any way that you want to do it. For a lot of people, and also myself, it is home.
In terms of the Black community at Harvard, I would say what is different about it is that we don't have an institutionalized space which is designated for us to meet. And that does make it hard. And so a lot of people find solace in those little individual pockets of BMF or BSA or HASA or Nigerian Students Association. And honestly, it does, in a sense, from time to time, create a lot of division.
You come here and it's the greatest institution in the country. And they don't have something as simple as like an African-American house. It's like, okay, well, you'll put us on your brochures, right? And you'll say we're committed to diversity and inclusivity, and we're committed to making sure that we feel comfortable and we feel welcome, but also that we can continue to explore our own identities. And that is like one of the most important things that's lost in the conversation.
Harvard is known for the email list, where every single black organization is on it, every single black organization gets the email, and that's where we disseminate all of the information that we see. So if we want to organize like a community-wide event or just have a dialogue with each other, it all comes across that email list. And like, in a way, it's like how we critique each other, it's how we talk to each other, but it's also one of the fastest and easiest ways that like we come together.
One of the ways in which I was able to kind of navigate my frustrations with my environment that I was going to school in with my environment back home was through dance. Expressions is a place where there are tons of people coming together and coordinating to complete one unified event, which is like a dance performance.
There was a student who was basically the victim of police brutality. We knew we had to make something that was relevant and that would capture the emotion that was being felt across the campus. And Ethan actually recommended the song 16 Shots by Vic Mensa, which talks about another past instance of police brutality. It was an entirely collaborative effort. We worked about 3 days, pretty much all day, just trying to pull some choreo together on time, each one of us contributing wholly, and then we performed it. This was just a small way that Rob and Ethan and I felt like we could contribute to the cause.
Let's continue to have some fun, let's continue to put that on our backs, and let's have a great show next week. All right, awesome.
All right.
Dope.
In high school, we didn't really feel like responsible to do something. And then you come to Harvard and then everyone is talking about like, oh, you guys have this platform, you gotta take like, you know, advantage of, you gotta like leverage it to like make impact. And like, I think like a sense of responsibility to like, you know, like address these issues that we are seeing, that we're learning about.
I used to hate talking about going to Harvard when I went back home because I was so afraid that I would be seen as different, you know what I'm saying? Like I abandoned like where I came from and stuff. And I remember the first day I decided to wear like my Harvard sweatpants that had like Harvard going all down my leg. And literally everybody would go here and down. It was more for me to get comfortable owning that than it was for like people to like, hey, look, I go to Harvard, because I wanted to. I wanted to be proud of the school that I went to because I knew it meant so much. You know, like me going to Harvard from where I came from is abnormal.
I spent a lot of my time using education as a way to leave the Bronx. But as I began to learn more about my borough and the ways in which it's been disenfranchised and how Black people, especially low-income Black people, have been disenfranchised and why my experiences exist, I want to do nothing more but go back. So what I'm arguing in this thesis is this, that Light Feet as a dance style, when performed by young Black men on subway cars in a phenomenon known as Showtime, provide these dancers a way in which that they can build both a collective and individual identity and connect with their community as well as the greater New York community on a deeper level.
I think that there's almost a climate here where students feel like it's their responsibility and duty not just to seek learning experiences in the classroom, but also in the community.
At Harvard, we get so sucked into our grades, into piece setting, into the day-to-day routine that a lot of times we forget to process and we get to breathe.
You live in this world of infinite possibility and in an environment that is consistently affirming you that you are someone who's valid in this world, right?
Yeah.
And that the ideas that you're preaching and that you want to go out into the world and create or develop is people are constantly saying, yes, you can do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you will do that. But when you leave all of that. Having the faith in yourself and being your own motivator, right?
Yeah.
Being your own person and say like, yeah, I can do this. I want to believe that I will be that person for myself, you know?
Yeah.
I want to believe that I will be able to tell myself when I leave this place that you can continue to change the world if you put your mind to it.
How is it like watching me evolve through these 4 years?
Oh, wow. I just can't explain it. I just want to make them cry. I'm just so proud of you. When I had you and I seen you for the first time, I just knew you was going to have great things in your life. I can't ask for that much.
I couldn't ask for a better mom. It's okay. I mean, I'm only able to be here because of the work that you did. This story is just beginning.
Thank